Hello my dear students, welcome back to the class once again. So in the previous class we discussed about some of the important features of the Government of India Act 1935. So on the basis of the Government of India Act 1935, election was to be held, and in the year 1937 election was held. So let me tell you, during that time altogether 11 provinces were there. 11 provinces were there. You will come to know which were the provinces, and elections were held in all the provinces, and what were the results, what was the mandate of the people, which party was given the mandate to form the government. So all those we'll be discussing, all those we'll discuss today in this class. So let's start with the topic, the election of 1937. Before that, the Government of India Act 1935, and according to the Government of India Act 1935, election was to be held. Okay, and in the year 1937 election was held. So when election was held, what was the result? Congress was there, Muslim League was there. So along with these two parties, other small parties were also there. Okay, parties like Krishak Praja Prati party was there, Unionist party was there, like regional parties, this type of parties were also there. So what was the result, what was the outcome of the election of 1937? Because for the first time the Indians were given a chance to form ministries in their respective provinces. Before that it was not there. So all this had been given to the Indians because in most of the times Indians supported the British government during the First World War even. Okay, and for that they wanted to give them some constitutional reforms. So this was the way they provided them with some sort of provincial autonomy, where the members of the legislature will rule the provinces without much interference from the governor as well as governor general. So the result of the election of 1937, first of all, clear cut majority. So Congress got clear cut majority in 5 provinces. Clear cut majority in 5 provinces. How many provinces? 5 provinces, clear cut majority. And which were the provinces? Let me tell you just for your knowledge. First one is United Province. United Province. Number 2, okay. First one is United Province. Number 2 is Bihar. Number 3 is Madras. Number 4 is CP, that is Central Province. Okay, and number 5 is, let me tell you, number 5 is Odisha. So these were the 5 provinces. These were the 5 provinces where Congress got a clear majority. Clear majority. Why I am telling you clear majority? Because in order to form the government, you need to have a numbers more than half. And if you get more than half numbers in the legislature, that means you have a clear majority to form the government. Suppose for example 400 seats are there in any of the provinces, then definitely you must get 201 or 202. That is a majority you need to form the government. So in 5 of the provinces, Congress got a clear majority to form the government. Clear majority to form the altogether 11 provinces were there. 11 provinces. So in the five provinces, Congress got a clear cut majority. Congress got clear cut majority. And in two of the provinces, Congress coalition government was there. Congress made alliances with other parties and there they formed the government. That also I'll tell you. Okay. So I hope you understood it. Five provinces where Congress got a clear cut majority. Now next, let me tell you. Congress emerged as a single largest party in four of the provinces. How many provinces? Four. Which were the four provinces? Number one, Bengal. Number two, NW Northwest Frontier Province. Number three, Assam. And number so these were the four provinces where Congress emerged as a single largest party. Congress emerged as a single largest party. So, single largest party in four of the provinces. Now, why I am giving you this detail? Because you need to understand properly how the election resulted in a conflict between the Muslim League and the Congress. Now, out of 482 seats. These seats, 482 seats were reserved as Muslim seats. 482 seats, Muslim reserved seats. 482 seats were reserved for the Muslims. I'm giving a very clear definition, clear cut explanation. 482 seats were reserved for the Muslims, but here also Congress contested 58 seats were contested by the Congress. So 58 seats were contested by the Congress. Okay. And amazing, you will be amazed to know that out of 58 seats, Congress could only win 26. How many? Congress could only win 26 seats. Out of 58, they could win only 26 seats. Okay. Now, what about the Muslims? What about the Muslim League? What was the result? Everywhere we see that Congress had own successfully the mandate of the people of India in the first election of 1937 was in favor of the Congress. Okay. Now Muslim League could not, just imagine, Muslim League could not win a single seat in Northwest Frontier Province. In a Northwest Frontier Province, Muslim could not win a single seat. Just imagine, in Northwest Frontier Province, this is the region where Muslim majority is there. Maximum people, the majority of people are Muslims. And here, Muslim League was rejected by the Muslims in general. So they could not win a single seat in a Northwest Frontier Province. Okay. And in Punjab, what about Punjab? In Punjab also, most of the people are Muslims. So in Punjab, out of 84, let me tell you, they got two seats out of how many? 84. In Punjab, Muslim League secured only two seats out of 84 seats reserved for the Muslims. Those seats were reserved for the Muslims, but ultimately you see there also they could not become successful. So here it is a clear mandate that gives us it tells us that the Muslim League was rejected in their own provinces, in their own Muslim majority provinces. So out of 84, just imagine, out of 84 they got only two seats in Punjab. In Northwest, 0 seat. in Northwest Frontier Province, they got a zero number of 6. Okay. Now next one. Next one, in 7 of the provinces, in the beginning I told you, know, in 5 of the provinces, Congress got a clear majority to form the government. Clear majority in 5 of the provinces. But altogether, out of 11 provinces, in 7 of the provinces, Congress government was formed. In 5 of the provinces, single party, they formed their government on their own. And in 2 of the other parties, in 2 of the provinces, a coalition government was formed. That I'll tell you which were the 7 provinces where Congress formed government. Number 1, 7 provinces. UFP. So, these were the 7 provinces where Congress formed the government. These were the 7 provinces where Congress formed their own government. Congress ministers were there. That means full majority government. Here the government was in full majority without entering into any alliances. So altogether 11, I say 11. Out of 11, they formed government in 9 provinces. 9 provinces. So 7. They have their own government, Congress government was there, and apart from these 7, 2 more provinces were there where Congress entered into the alliance. Coalition government was formed. There also, Congress was not in full majority, but they managed to enter into the alliance and form the government. And that two were number 8. I'm just continuing, okay, so that it will be easy for you to understand. Number 8, Assam. And number 9, you can say Sindh. So in 7 of the provinces, Congress full government, Congress majority government. And here they entered into the alliance. We can say the coalition government. Coalition government, which means Mili Juli Sarkar, entering into the alliance with other political parties and forming the government. So Assam and Sindh. Now, how many you see over here? 9. And I told you about 11 provinces were there during that time. During 1937, how many provinces were there? 11 provinces were there. So you just see, have a look, and I'll tell you which were the 2 provinces where Congress could not form their government. Not even Muslim League they formed the government. So go through that. Okay. So now next one, the 2 provinces where Congress could not form their government. Which were those 2 provinces? Let me tell you. Those 2 provinces were number 1, Bengal. And number 2, Punjab. So these were the 2 provinces where Congress could not form the government. Okay. So here which party formed the government? In Bengal, which party formed the government? It was Krishak. Krishak Praja Party. Krishak Praja Party. Okay, Krishak Praja Party formed the government. And Punjab, which party formed the government? Unionist. So these were the two provinces where Congress could not form government. So altogether. Out of 11, 7 of the provinces where Congress government was there with full majority, and in two of the provinces coalition government was formed, entering into the alliance with other political parties, and then remaining 2 other parties like Krishak Praja Party and Unionist Party, they formed the government. So this is the result This is the overall result of the election of 1937. Now, so once you are given the power, you know that with power comes the responsibility, and during the election time, the Congress even had promised to the people what all things they are going to change when they form the government. So one by one we'll be discussing about it again. So this is all over the result of 1937. I told you, hope you understood it clearly, and please go through the video. In the previous videos also I requested you all to go through the video, but hardly you people are managing time to watch the videos. So what to do? Once again I am requesting you all, it is for you only. We are taking such pain and we are putting our effort for you only. Please go through it. Now, next one is activities of Congress ministers. Activities of the Congress ministers. Activities of the Congress ministers. So after coming to power, after forming ministries in most of the provinces, what did they do? Did they fulfill the pre-election promises? Before the election, whichever promises were made by the Congress, did they fulfill it? Did they try to fulfill those promises? So of course they tried to some extent. So provincial autonomy was given to the provincial legislature. So let us see one by one. The first thing the Congress ministers did was they were committed to free the political prisoners. They are committed to free. They had promised that we will free the political prisoners. And who all are the political prisoners? Prisoners, we think that, oh, the robbers or the kidnappers or the criminals. No, it's not that. Political prisoners means those people, those who are involved in political activities. Okay? And that activity, that those activists, when they go against a particular party or a government, they are arrested and kept in the prison. They are known as political prisoners. They are not criminals. They are just a prisoners. They are kept in a prison because they had tried to go against the government. Those who went against the government or those who tried to go against the government, they are the political prisoners. So it was the effort. That is why through the intervention of Gandhiji, 1100 detainees of Bengal were released. 1100. The first thing they did was 1100. Okay, 1100 detainees. That means they were detained. There was no case, nothing. They were arrested and they were put into the prison without any trial and all. Simply, they were kept into the prison without any trial and all. So, they were detained. So, 11. Okay, 1100. It is not 11. 1100. Okay, let me make it more clear. 1100 detainees were freed. Okay. And number two, in UP, in Uttar Pradesh, or you can say that United Province, many of the prisoners, including the Kakori prisoners, they were released. Kakori prisoners. Okay, let me explain you. Kakori prisoners were released. So, along with other prisoners, Kakori prisoners were also released. Now, what is mean by Kakori prisoners, or who were they? So, it is mentioned that on 9th of August 1925, ten revolutionaries stopped a train at Kakori, in a place called Kakori. Okay, that is a village near Lucknow, Kakori is a village station near Lucknow, and looted the railway cash. The cash which was there in the rail was looted by these revolutionaries. So for that they were arrested. So they were known as Kakori prisoners. So they were the Kakori. Then they were arrested in a place called Kakori when they tried to stop the train, and they looted, or we can say that they took away the cash from the train. Okay, so they looted the cash from the prison in a place called Kakori. So they were Kakori prisoners. So along with the other prisoners, Kakori prisoners were also released. Okay, then next one, many of the political leaders, they were exiled. Okay, like Raj Bihari Bose, Prithvi Singh, Maulvi Abdullah Khan, and Ambani Mukherjee. Okay, so they are exiled. There are a lot of restrictions were there on their political activities. So the restrictions were removed over them. That means restrictions were removed from them. They were in exile. So during their stay in exile also, a lot of restrictions were there. Those restrictions were removed. Okay, and who were the leaders? Raj Bihari Bose, Prithvi Singh, Maulvi Abdullah Khan, Ambani Mukherjee. Okay, got it? But after removing the restrictions also, they could not do much. Those leaders could not do much. The next one, suspension order. These are the Congress activities, I'm telling you, activities of Congress ministers. So, suspension order on political parties and similar organizations were revoked. That means many of the political parties were suspended. Okay, many of the political, political parties, they were suspended, and those suspension orders were revoked. Revoked means withdrawn. Revoked means withdrawn. The suspension orders were revoked. Means revoked means withdrawn. Okay, so they managed to do so. And next one, number five, press was granted the right of free criticism. That is a great achievement. Press was given a freedom to criticize freely. So when this was given, that means they can criticize the working of the government even. Okay, so press was granted the right of free criticism. Press was granted the right of free criticism. Yes. The next activity they did was in Madras province. In Madras also they had formed the government. In Madras province also they became successful in remitting the taxes of the peasants. They remitted the taxes of the peasants from the government. They managed to give it. That means many of the peasants, they take loan from the moneylenders, sometimes from the government, no? They could not pay, so they were remitted. Maaf kar dena. Okay, they were remitted. That is good. That is also good. In Bombay and UP, in Bombay and United Province, interest on agricultural loans was reduced. Interest on agricultural loan was reduced. We take loan from the banks, no? And bank charge interest from the customers. So, those interest from the farmers were reduced. Those interest from the farmers were reduced. The next one, in Bombay Ministry, in Bombay. In Bombay also, Congress had their government. Congress ministers were there. So, in Bombay Ministry, the government passed in 1938 Industrial Dispute Act. Industrial Dispute Act was passed. Industrial Dispute Act was passed and wages of mill hands were increased. Wages of mill hands, those who work in mills, their wages were increased. But due to Industrial Dispute Act, later on problem was also there that we'll discuss later on. Okay, so in 1938, Bombay Ministry passed the Industrial Dispute Act. Whenever there will be a dispute in industries between the workers and the owner, according to the act, what will be the provision, what will be the solution, that will be followed. Then, the next activity they performed was, license for selling intoxicating drugs were restricted. License for selling intoxicating drugs. Intoxicating means poisonous, which is harmful for our internal organs. Like a cigarette is injurious for health. Drugs, medicines, which are categorized as drugs, if you take in large quantities, then definitely that will also be harmful. Okay, so license of selling intoxicating drugs were restricted. Okay, then there was a big issue, there was a burning issue during that time when Congress ministries were formed, when Congress government was formed. What was that? Okay, so that was tenancy legislation. Tenancy legislation, that means I am the tenant on your land, and certain rules and regulations which are to be followed, there was a problem regarding that. So peasant problem was a burning issue. The Congress ministries which they formed, they gave a new hope among the peasantry class regarding the tenancy act. Certain sort of tenancy act definitely the peasants were hoping for. So the tenancy legislation was taken up in all Congress ruled provinces. So in all the Congress ruled provinces, tenancy legislation, that means legislation for tenancy, was introduced. So it has to go through a process, no? Legislature is a law making body, so process has to start. So in all the Congress ruled provinces, tenancy legislation was taken up. Then the next one, everywhere efforts were made to protect the peasants from the clutches of the moneylenders. Everywhere moneylenders, they always dominate money. That means the peasants always suffers in the hand of the moneylenders. So everywhere they tried their best to free the peasants from the clutches of moneylenders by providing them irrigation facilities. Okay, irrigation facilities were increased for the peasants and all. Okay, so this was a time. Actually, this was a time. Okay, it was a transition period. It was a time, my dear, where awakening among the peasants were come. That means the peasants were very much conscious about their rights, what actually they should get. So that was a time of awakening among the peasants. So this is all about the activities of the Congress ministers. So when they formed the government, they started working on this. So one by one, they started working on that. So apart from all this, many laws were also passed. Let me tell you about that also. Apart from these activities, laws were passed for the workers. Laws. Laws were passed for the workers to protect the interests of the workers. Laws were passed. Okay, like in 1937, labor committee was set up to frame. Okay, and what all should be included in order to protect the people, workers in general. So number one, what all were included? What all were included when they make a law? Whether that law was passed, that is something different. But what all were included in order to protect the interests of the workers? Number one, holiday with pay. What is the meaning of holiday with pay? When you work, you are paid. When you don't work, you are not paid. Okay? Suppose, for example, I work and I am paid the salary for the whole month. If I am not paid the salary for Sundays and on holidays, then that would be unfair for me. So on Sundays, I'll go somewhere else and work. Is that possible? No. So in order to make it secure, holidays were there. If there is any holiday during the month or some sort of pujas are there, so you can remain at home and you will be paid for that. You will be paid for that. Holiday with pay. Then next one is number two. Leave, okay, with pay. Leave with pay during sickness. Leave with pay during sickness. Suppose you are sick. If a worker is sick, will he be paid? Definitely, he will get the sick leave. That means you will get the salary and that will be counted as sick leave. You have taken a leave because you are sick, but you will be paid for that. Okay, so this were the process they wanted to include in the laws passed for the workers. Okay, the next one was employment insurance. I work for a firm, and if anything happens to me, then what about my family? So for that, employment insurance. Okay, employment insurance. Employment insurance. That means insurance will be done during your employment. If anything happens, then you'll be insurance companies will pay. Okay. And number three, to fix minimum wages. Minimum wages should be there. How much should a male or a female get? Minimum should be there. That should not be given low or that should not be given high. That is something different. Minimum wages must be given to the worker. Minimum wages should be given to the workers. Okay. And number five, what did they mention? Number five, recognition of trade union. Okay. So, recognitions of trade union. Trade union should be recognized. So, trade union should be recognized. So, this were the points which they wanted to include while passing the law. So as I told you earlier also, as I told you just before starting this topic, that Industrial Dispute Act was passed by the Bombay Presidency. So what happened after that Bombay Presidency? So there was a lot of problem. There was a problem between the labor and the owner, and due to that, Industrial Dispute Bill was introduced in order to prevent the strikes and lockouts. Suppose, for example, if you are not paid properly, you'll go for a strike. If hundreds and hundreds of workers are working in a factory, if they are not paid properly, the demands are not fulfilled, then they'll go for a strike. They'll lock. There will be a lockout. So during the lockout, who suffers? The workers will also suffer and the owner will also suffer. So if this continues, that will hamper the development of the country. For the proper development of the country, there should be a good relation between the workers and the owner, because they are the one who gives stability to the economy of the country. So Industrial Dispute Bill was passed in order to prevent strikes, lockout as far as possible. But this gave a very wrong signal. This gave a very wrong signal to the workers. They thought that this act is going to suppress our rights. This act will suppress our rights to protest against injustice done to us by our owner. So ultimately, this movement was suppressed with the help of police authority. There was a huge protest by the workers, because they thought that the Industrial Dispute Bill was going to harm their civil liberties. So this movement was suppressed by the help of police authority. Okay. Then again in Kanpur, there was a strike. There was a strike in Kanpur where 24,000 workers went on strike demanding higher wages. Their demand was higher wages. And number two, their demand was better living conditions. They wanted higher wages and better living condition. Living condition is also very important. I work to live peacefully, and if I cannot maintain my standard, what is the use of living? So the workers, they demanded better wages as well as better living condition. Ultimately, this dispute was settled by the ministry. The Congress ministry, they settled the dispute between the workers and the owner. Okay, the similar movement was similar type of case was found in Bengal also, where jute mill workers went on for a strike. In Bengal, jute mill workers went on for a strike. Okay, in Bengal. So here also you can see TISCO workers also, Tata Iron and Steel Company, there also a strike was going on. So here also TISCO is in Jamshedpur, so there also a strike was going on. So important leaders of the Congress like Jawaharlal Nehru, okay, then Rajendra Prasad acted as a mediator between the worker and the owner, worker leader and the owner, and they tried to sort out the problems. So this was the time, my dear, this was a period, my dear, important features were going, important features were seen being changed, okay, and even the leftist group was becoming more and more active. Leftist group always work in order to demand for the rights of the workers. So leftist group was becoming more and more influencing over the working class. Okay. So during that period, what were the achievements of the Congress? So what were the achievements of the Congress? Number one, Congress ministers became successful. What were the achievements of the Congress? Achievement of the Congress, number one. Let me tell you one by one. What were the achievements of the Congress, Congress ministers? Achievement. Achievement of the Congress ministries. Okay, one by one. Did they achieve anything? Number one, they managed to reduce, okay, the salary of the ministers. Salaries of the ministers were reduced so that the amount can be utilized for the other people. Okay, reduction of salaries of ministers. Ministers' salaries were reduced. Then number two, welfare scheme for the tribals. Welfare scheme for the tribals were also introduced. Number three, jail reforms. There was reforms being brought in the jail. Jail reforms. Then declaration of fundamental rights. Declaration of fundamental rights. So let me write it so that you can understand it. Number one, reduction. Reduction of Salaries of the Congress ministers. Okay, number two, welfare schemes. Welfare schemes for the tribals. Okay, for the tribals. So this two and number three and four, just you go through it. Jail reforms. Number three, jail reforms, and number four, declaration of fundamental rights. So children, so I tried my best to make you understand about the results of election of 1937, as well as the activities of the Congress ministers when they formed the government, and when ministers, they were given the responsibility to fulfill the promises made before the election. So they were given those responsibilities. Then during their tenure, laws were also passed. Industrial Dispute Act also was passed. So all this thing happened, my dear. And for the first time, we can witness that the Congress ministers or the Congress was given the responsibility to act as a part of the government. Though diarchy was at the center, but diarchy was removed from the provinces, provinces were given autonomy as per the Government of India Act 1935. So children, I hope you have understood this topic. See you in the next class. Till then, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.